Good morning everyone. Today we learn about 10th class lesson, first chapter, Indian Relief Futures. India, it is a country name. Relief Futures, different types of landforms. Look at this picture children. This is map 1, location of India in the world map. This map is world map, we know everyone. But what is the meaning of location of India in the world? It means where it is locating our India in the world. See children, our India is locating North Hemisphere as well as Eastern Hemisphere. See children, in down given in textbook, the based on our textbook, location. The second point we can check children here, latitudes and longitudes to the base of our India, where it is to locate very easily to particularly, we can say that one. See children, here latitudes and longitudes. First one, 0 degree equator. It is a full circle. It is very near of our India. And another one, prime meridian. This is the standard timeline, meridian line. This prime meridian is also 0 degree to 1 degree to count from the east side 180 degrees and same like that west side 0 to 1 degree to 180 degree. Total 360 degrees as well as 0 degree equator to consider from the upper part all 90 degrees and down also to 90 degrees. It's total 180 degrees. It means our India is the meridian line is to going on 82 degrees and off inches. It is the standard time of our Indian standard time. See children, it is given well detailed in your textbook in this map. Our India is locating in this map 8 degrees 4 inches to 37 degrees 6 inches north. See children, it is only north only it is given. 88 degrees 4 inches north to 37 degrees 6 inches north as well as it is the length of our India as well as 68 degrees 7 inches east to 97 degrees 25 inches east. It means it here also to east to east. It means our India is locating in the world North Hemisphere as well as Eastern Hemisphere. Children, we not to write our boundaries like that. Why? Our boundary is upper, it is Himalayas and down north is Himalayas, south is Indian Ocean. East is Bay of Bengal and west is Arabian Sea. Then now it is given east to east only. We cannot write here 68 degrees 7 inches west. You can write like this means, see children, here it is given very detailedly W it means it is all west place. The west zone is also to consider same like that the given to measuring from this scale like this also to here also. This all it is given E means all east. Here it is given west which means all west. We can write like this our India is 68 degrees and 7 inches W west means it is wrong answer. To check everybody from that one, it is our width It is 2,933 kilometers. Width is 2,933 kilometers. Our India is a standard meridian line is 82 degrees 30 inches. This is our standard time. See children, here one more thing I will tell you. What is that one? Arunachal Pradesh to the here to this all this line is the standard time. Here to be measuring from this side, it is 4 minutes to added, and here to this one it is to less. See children, that's why it is east 68 degrees 7 inches east. Here to we added 4 4 4 4 4 4. That's why here came this one is 97 degrees 25 inches. And same like this, this also latitudes. The latitudes is 8 degrees and 4 inches north. Not to we added from like this our how many or from that latitudes, then it is covered 37 degrees and 6 inches north. It is 8 degrees, it means our India is locating very heated zone. 0 to 10 degrees, it is temperature zone. It is a tropical zone. And after, we know the Tropic of Cancer also to pass it on our India. It is 23 and off degrees. And same like that, it is to pass it on 37 degrees and 6 inches. It means it is the zone of temperature zone. And see children, and here what is saying about our map, the map is saying about our India is to stretched from that 8 degrees to 37 degrees 6 inches north. It means that's why our India is called subcontinent. We have many geographical features like a continent. These all latitudes and longitudes are imaginary lines. We particularly we know about from that our India is the place and time. For example, one latitude to another latitude to pass down 111 degrees to one latitude to another latitude length. And same like that as well as the 1 degree to one meridian to another meridian, it is passed on 4 minutes. It means these helps of from that latitudes and longitudes. We know about the correct particular place and time. We know about our India is where it is locating and how much time it is going on from that whatever the time. Yes, no, children? Now it is the second topic. And one more thing, children. Here is, it is 0 to 90 degrees north and 0 to 90 degrees south. It is all 180 degrees latitudes and it includes 0 degree. It is 181 latitudes. The total latitudes are 181 latitudes. And see children, the next point is based on our textbook. Look at here. Geological background. The geological background means how is, in based on our textbook, how is India form? See children, look at in this picture. It is to based on our 9th class textbook. Movements of the earth, earth's crust. See children, 220 million years ago. The earth is formed like this. All continents are here to mingled one part. It is called Pangaea. All water body it is called Panthalassa. When it is 200 million years ago, the Tethys Sea is cutted Did you see cutted the earth two parts? The upper land it is called Angara land. The down part this land is called Gondwana land. Many years passed, 135 million years ago, the earth is skipped like this. And after many years struggle, the earth is looked like this. See here children, our India is 90% of the peninsular area is covered with this Australia plate. And 10% is covered with Eurasia plate. When the Eurasian plate and Australia plate is come near to dash it, the folding of the land is increased the mountains. These mountains is called newborn Himalayas, young mountains. Next point, major relief divisions. See children here, the relief features of India land mass can be divided into the following groups. First one is Himalayas, second one is the Indo-Gangetic Plain, third one is the Peninsular Plateau, fourth one is the Coastal Plains, fifth one is desert, sixth one is the islands. We can discuss one by one. Look at here children. It is the Himalayas. The Himalayas is covered like this. See here. First one, the first range, it is called the Great Himalayas or Inner Himalayas and Himadri. This level is, see, here is stretched like this. 500 kilometers to width to west to east, it is 200 kilometers. And distance is 2400 kilometers. The range of, in this range of the Himalayas covered, the height is considered 6100 meters. Inner Himalayas are covered with snow. The covered with snow area, it is called glaciers. These glaciers melting are resources of Penarial rivers. The Penarial rivers flow through the year. Penarial rivers are, for example, like Indus River, Ganga River, and Brahmaputra River. In these glaciers, feed with these Penarial rivers. In this region, we can find highest peak, Mount Everest. Mount Everest. In Nepal, 8,848 meters, and same like that our India, K2 Karakoram, in it is 8,611 meters. Next parallel range is the second one, the Lesser Himalayas or Himachal. See children, this one, it is this range are mainly composed of highly compressed rocks and most rugged relief land. This Lesser Himalayas height is 3,700 to 4,500 meters from west to east. Here is the mainly the famous place is Pir Panjal in Jammu Kashmir. Here also we can find it from the great valleys Banihal Pass, Pir Panjal Pass, and also famous valleys Kashmir, Kangra, Kulu. These all also we can find from these region only. This region is well known for many hill stations like Simla, Mussoli, Nainital, etc. And these region covered by evergreen forest also. The second one, the third one, the range, it is called a syllabic, the syllabic range. It is called another name, outer Himalayas also. See children here, this width is 10 to 50 kilometers west to east. The height is 900 to 1100 meters. These Himalayas take a hairpin band. These Himalayas called hairpin band, like a pin, how much it is covered, like this, like this. In this range, famous of valleys living between the Laser to Shivalik range are called as dunes, like Dehra Dune, Kotali Dune, Patali Dune, etc. Another famous range has Purvanchal. It is covered mostly the sediment rocks, sand and stones. Here has many hill stations like Patakai Hills, Naga Hills, Manipuri Hills, Kasi Hills, Mizoram Hills, etc. Look at this picture, children. The first level one, no vegetation. Here's, look at here. On the top of the mountains, there is no vegetation. These are covered with glaciers. The second level, only grass. This grass is covered from the second level. And next, third level, coniforms. Coniforms is or cone shaped trees like this. See children, look at here. Cone shaped trees. These plants are like a redwood, and another one very soft and straight wood plants. And these plants make like a matchbox, paper and house furniture, these all things. Here the climate is, the winters are very cold, summer are warm. This climate largely control the growth of plants life. These trees are tall and soft. For example, pine trees and fir trees, etc. Next one, see children here, the level 4, boat trees. Boat trees, it is covered very big leaves. For example, banana trees. Like that, the boat trees are covered from this region. Not more many branches. The leaves only to cover from these boat trees. And next level, it is a fifth level, Tarai. Tarai is at the foot of the mountains. It is Tarai with the trees covered from this region. Influence of Himalayas. The formation of Himalayas influence Indian's climate in various ways. Yes, no, children? It means what, that one? See, children, these Himalayas are like a wall. For example, in China wall. China wall is somebody built it, but it is the naturally the God grace to given from these Himalayas for our country. See, children. And outside from that, abroad to come from, for example, the Asia, Central Asia to the in winter season, come from these winter cold winds, not to come from that our India. It is stopped from these Himalayas. And one more thing, these Himalayas are not located in our India. It is turned into like a desert. Why it is means, see children, the desert wind, hot summer winds, also to come from that here, to reach here, then it is converted from that in rainy season from the rain. And one more thing, see children, here to come from that west part to and down south part to come from that monsoons. These monsoons also, they not to go out from that abroad, Asia and another countries. Why? These Himalayas are very, it is very high, it is enlarged very heights. That for example, in like this Everest is a 8,848 kilometers, that much of the Himalayas range. It means our monsoons ways also, it come reflect back only. It to reach here to come reflect to back like this. And then one more thing, the Himalayas rivers have perennial rivers also to feed these Himalayas glaciers. That's why the and one more thing like that, the perennial rivers to through the year it is flowing. That's why these all soil here from these Indo-Gangetic plains are from that very fertile soil to here. Indo-Gangetic plains, northern plains. See children, this is called Indo-Gangetic plains. These Indo-Gangetic plains beginning 20 million years ago. The first one is the western part, this one is central part, and this one is eastern part. This region is locating down Shivalik range. See children, this is very fertile soil. Here the very fertile soil, and one more thing, it is plenty of water, the favorable climate also. That's why in this area more population density in this area, starting in the part west in northern plains to come first in this part, the Indus River Basin. See children, this Indus and its tributaries. See children, the here it is, the tributaries are Zelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias and Satluj rivers. This Satluj river originated in Himalayas too. See children, in this rivers lies fertile soil in Punjab, in here in Punjab region. This northern plain, this Punjab region, it is called northern plains and as well as Punjab plains also. Indus rivers mainly flow in Pakistan only. In our India, to Punjab to flow in these tributaries also. That's why it is called in this area Punjab. Punjab means panch, and ab means panch, means five rivers. Ab means water. Five rivers to flow in Punjab. That's why it is called Punjab. And one more thing children, in Punjab to Haryana, in this middle area, it is called Dob. Dob means, Dob means to, Ab means water. It means Dob also to, here only we can to saw. Punjab in our India, it is very fertile soil here. And one more thing, it is middle plains, Gangetic plains. It's central plains. See children, it is Gangetic basin. The middle plain lies between Gagra and Tista. This one it is living between Gagra to Gagra, here to Gagra, like this to Tista. In these two river flow between from these basin. Ganga river flows Haryana, Delhi, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand, West Bengal. Also very rich fertile soil. That's why the Haryana is called rice bowl of India. See children, another one, the Brahmaputra plains lies in only Assam region. This region called the heaven of India. In these northern plains or Indo-Gangetic plains are called the heaven of India. Why means children, we know that one. The Himalayas rivers while flowing down to like this, and this area to deposit the pebbles and sediment rocks in a narrow belt. In a narrow belt of 8 to 16 kilometers. In the belt, the first one, it is here Babar. Babar is a deep underground water pebbles deposited by river and down of Sivaliks. The next belt in here, and the belt is four stages children. The first one is Babar, the second one is Terai. This land is has wet, and one more thing, swampy and marshy land with a lot of springs. Next belt children, the next belt one is, first one is Babar, the second one is Terai, and third one is Bangar. Bangar is a large part of from that here, the in this basin. The Bangar region formed of Abel alluvium and is the largest part of in this soil. And fourth one is Kadi. Alluvial deposits here from that rich fertile soil in this region. It is to use it for agriculture. Another point, Peninsular Plateau. First of all, what is the meaning of this peninsular? Peninsular means three sides of water and one side land. Plateau. Plateau means table land. See children, this land is look like a table. And when it is formed, this table land? See children, in our India, it is formed from that Gondwana land. The Gondwana land, it is broken in that time to the pieces to form like this part. This peninsular plateau is very old region. This plateau is to covered crystalline stone, igneous stone, and metabolic stones. This peninsular plateau is divided into two regions. See children, here Malwa Plateau and Chota Nagapur Plateau. It is Narmada River to cut it from this plateau. Upper one it is Northern Plateau and down one it is Deccan Plateau. This upper Northern Plateau is called the Central Highland. This Central Highland lives northern of the river Narmada. It's covered majority of Malwa Plateau. This is the Malwa plateau, children. And next, it is divided north India and southern India. The southern India and north India, it is divided this Vindhya range. This Vindhya range mountains. And one more thing, children, this Malwa plateau on west side towards the east. See, children, here there is a Chota Nagpur plateau. And see, and apart from that, here the Deccan plateau lives to the south of Narmada River. This plateau is Deccan plateau is look like a triangular shape. This is called a triangular landmass. On west side, west side, this side it is called Western Ghats. And on the eastern side, Eastern Ghats. See, we can compare these both. See, children, here Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats, there are number of differences. The Western Ghats lies parallelly western coastal area. See, they are no cutting at all, it going parallelly. And here it is crossed three ghats. That one here is Tal Ghat, and one more here is Bor Ghat. This Tal Ghat, Bor Ghat, between this Mumbai, the coastal area. And after here, it down, it is come from that another ghat. It is here Pal Ghat. This Pal Ghat, it is located past on Tamil Nadu. This side, Eastern Ghats. The Eastern Ghats stretched the Mahanadi Valley to Nilagiri in the south. Nilagiri Hills in the south. These Eastern Ghats are discontinued. They have some breaks. And one more thing, it is irregular also. They are interspread with several rivers here, here, and here, and here, and here. The several rivers the drain into Bay of Bengal. These rivers like Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, like this here is Mahanadi, like this all rivers. And one more thing, to comparison of both heights from the Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. See, children, it is given 2000 meters. These Western Ghats all are from that above 2000 meters, 16 kilometers. And here is from that famous hill station, Udakamandalam or Ooty. And next, located in Nilagiri and Todabetta. It is 2637 meters. And highest, it is the highest peak in Western Ghats. And same like that, the Western Ghats, the another famous one, it is Annaimudi. Annaimudi is 2695 meters. These Eastern Ghats, to see, children, its heights only from that 900 kilometers only, to comparatively.
And one more thing, the highest peak in Eastern Ghats, it is Aroma Konda, found in Chintapalli. It is 1680 meters in Andhra Pradesh. And Nallamalai hills and these all Palakondas, and these all are located in Eastern Ghats. Another point, Thar Desert. The Thar Desert is located on Aravali Hills. See children, the west side in the map from here, this west side in the, it located in Rajasthan. Here, very little rainfall in this region. For example, 100 to 150 mm per year. The desert consists and here from the climate. The climate is very low vegetation. It means, we know from that the sand definition. The sand is absorb heat very fastly, and same like that it reduce heat very fastly. It means the daytime is very hot, and same like that, and night time it is very cool. And one more thing here to see children, Luni is the only river in this area. The Luni river is, and seasonally it is to flow on in this desert area, Thar Desert, but when it is come from the summer, it is dry. And one more thing children, Indira Gandhi canal is the largest canal in the country. It is our country in India, 650 kilometers. This Indira Gandhi canal only to feed in this desert area to irrigation and householding needs. The coastal plains. See children, here in this map, these all it is called the coastal plains in this green part. See here, these coastal plains, India is blessed with very long coastal line. It began from here, Arabian Sea to on the west to Bay of Bengal east, starting from the Gulf Kutch in western coastal plain. It moves south onwards along the boundaries of Maharashtra, Goa, Karnataka, Kerala, and it stretch lastly Kanyakumari. Most tip of the India, this mainland of Kanyakumari. This Kanyakumari runs northwards to reach West Bengal. Here, West Bengal. This coastal line is very useful for our country, fishing and agriculture. And one more thing children to see, look at here. And this other part of the west coastal, it have a three main points. First one is, it based on our textbook, Konkan Plains. This Konkan Plains is very rich oil deposits. And next, Kanaran Coast. This Kanaran Coast is located in Karnataka. This Konkan is from the Goa and between the Maharashtra. And another one, the Malabar Coast. This Malabar Coast is it is in Kerala. Apart as well as from this eastern coastal also, this eastern coastal is broadly, it is to occupied from this region. This coastal plains is to see children here, it is northern Sarkar. The Sarkar plains it is called from this region. Another one, it is in Tamil Nadu in here to Coromandel coastal. Another point, the islands. And India have, look it in this map children, India have majorly two islands. This is Eastern Islands, Andaman Nicobar Islands. And one more thing here from the west side, Lakshadweep Islands. It means lakhs of these all islands. That's why these are the importance of this Lakshadweep. The corals we can to locate from this region. And here the Nicobar bird is also to come from that name, Andaman Nicobar. India has many relief features. That's why our India is called subcontinent. Thank you children. If you like my video, like my video and subscribe my videos.